This is MJ with MinIO. In today's video, we'll show you how to use the mc mirror command to mirror files to and from your MinIO environments. So a little bit about the mc mirror command. The mc mirror command synchronizes content to the MinIO deployment, similar to how the rsync utility would work. MC mirror supports file systems, as in your local file system, MinIO deployments, and other S3 compatible hosts as the synchronization source. Please note that MC mirror only synchronizes the current object without any version information or metadata. If you want to sync the object's version history and metadata, consider using the MC replicate or MC admin replicate commands. So here are some examples of the MC mirror command. You could use MC mirror local mirror and mirror that to MinIO 1 mirror bucket 1. That will take the local files that are in local mirror and move them to mirror bucket 1. In the next command, you could use MC mirror and mirror MinIO 1 mirror bucket 1 to another MinIO deployment, MinIO 2 mirror bucket 2. You could also use MC mirror dash dash watch and watch the local mirror folder, and anything that's added to that folder will automatically be replicated, or rather mirrored, to MinIO 1 mirror bucket 1. You could also define a time period, so you could use something like MC mirror dash dash older than 1 day. And then anything that's older than 1 day would get mirrored from MinIO 1 mirror bucket 1 to MinIO 2 mirror bucket 2. And lastly, mirroring does not automatically overwrite. It gives an error. So if a file of the same name exists on the remote host already, it won't let you do that. But if you use MC mirror dash dash overwrite and local mirror and then MinIO 1 mirror bucket 1, it will overwrite the existing files in the remote directory if they're different. Let's take a look at the docs and understand that behavior a little bit better. You'll note here that mirroring continues on a failed object. If an object of the same name exists on the target, MinIO outputs an error for the duplicate object. MC mirror continues to mirror other objects from the source to the destination after the error. So that's important because that's why we have to use the overwrite command. Also note that if you are using a directory, let's say you're mirroring from the local to a remote MinIO host, and that directory has subdirectories, any subdirectories that are created on that remote host, but then if you update that directory that's being mirrored and it's no longer has any files in it, that directory, or prefix in this case, as it's called in MinIO object storage, will be removed when that prefix is empty, because you've also emptied the related mirroring source. As always, here are some links to the documentation. We'll put these in the description. Please follow along with the documentation, as these instructions and versions will be updated over time. Let's jump into a lab environment. So here we are in our lab environment, and I'm on my local system in a directory called local mirror. Let's take a look and see what's in the mirror bucket one on the MinIO 1 alias. We can see that there's a single file in there. So one option that you could use this for is to mirror what's in a remote bucket to your local system. Let's go ahead and do that. We can now see that the file test.txt that was in the remote mirror bucket 1 bucket is now on our local system. We could also use this to mirror our local file system to a remote system as well. Here we are in the lab environment, and we are in a local directory called local mirror. First thing we're going to do is mirror remote files in a bucket to our local system. We can use the mc mirror command and target MinIO 1 alias test bucket 2. And mirror that to the local directory. We can see here that we have the mirror files from that remote bucket now on our local system. Let's go ahead and mirror everything in our local mirror to the remote bucket, MinIO 1 mirror bucket 1. And now if we do an mcls on MinIO 1, we can see all of the files that are in our local directory have now been mirrored up to that remote bucket. There's another cool switch that you can use in here called the watch switch. This will allow us to watch changes in the local mirror or even a remote bucket and automatically mirror those changes to another destination. So we'll go ahead and get this running. So now we'll go ahead and use this command to create some random 100 meg files and watch them get automatically uploaded to the remote system. You can see that as soon as I started creating those files, the system here picked up that a change was made in local mirror and started copying all of those files to the mirror bucket one. So let's first look at the local system. We can see that there are a number of 100 meg files that were created locally. Let's go take a look at the remote system now. And we can see that those files have automatically been mirrored to that because this command was actually watching this local mirror for changes and automatically copying those files up to the remote system. We can also use some additional switches that are available in the command, like exclude. So in this case, the dash dash exclude command in start.pdf will ignore any PDF files, but mirror everything else in the directory. So we'll go ahead and set that watch up, and then we'll go ahead and generate some files. First thing we're going to do is generate PDFs. If we look at the local directory, you can see that there are a number of PDF files here, but this has not picked them up because we've told it to ignore. However, let's say we were to create some MP4 video files. We can see that those have been created as well as MP4s. But now this system has picked that up. And if we go back and look at the other system, MinIO 1, Mirror Bucket 1, we can see that only the MP4 files were copied because we chose to exclude that. Hopefully this video gave you a good quick start on how to start using the MC mirror command. As always, you can visit us at min.io for more information or join us at slack.min.io to become part of discussion. Thanks for watching.